to our second week of GSM Daily Devotions. We're so happy to have you here with us studying in the Word once every day. We're going to be continuing our series on the Beatitudes, so let's go ahead and open up in prayer together. Oh Lord, let my soul rise up to meet you as the day rises to meet the sun. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Our scripture today is Matthew chapter 5, verse 8. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Many theologians have pondered this particular beatitude for centuries. You may recall scriptures from the Old Testament that mention if you see God, you'll die. Particularly Exodus 33:20 is one that we might remember. But God said, "You cannot see my face. No one shall see me and live." Gregory of Nyssa, a saint in the early Christian church, was particularly puzzled with this beatitude as he compared the Old Testament scriptures to what Jesus says here in Matthew. And he ended up with some incredible findings that I think may help us understand this scripture today. First, Gregory believes that anyone can see God simply by looking at the created world around them. So if you were literally just to look at nature around you, you would see God and that beautiful creation. But then Gregory wondered, what more could the pure in heart see, according to this verse in Matthew? Gregory points to the words of Jesus in Luke 17:21. For in fact, the kingdom of God is among you. And by looking at all these scriptures together, he concludes that, and he has this quote from his book on the Beatitudes. Jesus does not seem to me to be offering God as an instant vision to the one whose spiritual eye is purified. The person who has purified his own heart from the very tendency to passion, that is, unruly emotion, perceives in his own beauty the effulgence of the divine nature. So in other words, humans, as created beings made in the image of God, can look inside themselves and see God. Since the fall of Adam and Eve in Genesis 3, humans have looked a little bit less like the image of God, as that image has been covered up with the dirtiness of sin. But the blood of Jesus Christ washes over us and makes us clean. The work of Jesus Christ in us makes us pure and holy. As we seek the love of Christ to change us from the inside out every single day, and our hearts are continually being made pure, more and more pure, then we will be able to see God. And more specifically, we will be able to see God within ourselves as his very image is being restored in us. Take some time in prayer today. And first, begin with thanking God for his image in you that has made you a beautiful and wonderful creation. And second, begin asking him to reveal to you if there's anything impure in your heart that might be covering up his image. And finally, ask Jesus to come in and remove those impurities and purify your heart fully so that his beautiful image may be revealed inside of you. This is the work of holiness, which we must remember to engage in every day of our lives as followers of Christ. Receive this blessing today. Hold out your hands so that you can receive it. May the peace of the Lord Christ go with you, wherever he may send you. May he guide you through the wilderness, protect you through the storm. May he bring you home rejoicing at the wonders he has shown you. May he bring you home rejoicing once again into our doors. Thank you for joining us for our week 2, day 1 of Daily Devotions. We'll see you again tomorrow.